guys, it's Angelina and Dima here from Walking Edge World, and today we're coming to you with a new gear comparison video. And this time it is going to be a comparison of two different cooking systems, a gas stove and a wood stove. As you may already know from our previous videos, we discovered the wood stove only this year and have been testing it a lot. And the gas stove has been our go-to cooking setup since the beginning, so we have more than 3 years of experience with it.
We thought it would be interesting to compare these two systems, as they're quite different from each other, and talk more about some pros and cons of each one. So without further introduction, let's get started with the comparison.
First of all, I wanted to start by saying that this is going to be more of a generic comparison of two cooking systems rather than a detailed one. So I won't compare and refer to the particular brands or models of the products, nor compare the technical specs.
And if you wish to learn more in-depth information about any of the items we'll show you in this video, please go ahead and watch our separate gear reviews. But here we just want to share our personal perceptions and impressions after using both of these systems.
So let's begin with the pros and cons of the gas system. If we could describe the gas system in one phrase, we would say that it is the ease of use and a fast heating. You don't need to search and collect any fuel under your feet, and thus it saves you the precious time. It is quite safe and you don't have to worry about looking for a particular place to set it up, because there is no open fire and it is easy to control. You can even cook inside your tent vestibule if necessary in the moments when it rains or the weather is bad. While cooking, you can still do other things and it doesn't require your full attention and presence. The boiling of the water under right conditions can be very fast and done in a couple of minutes with little effort. When you're done cooking, your pot is always clean and not covered with soot. Also, nothing will have a smell of the smoke that can happen quite frequently with the wood stove. So overall, this system is the most versatile, convenient and easy to use. The flame is adjustable and quite economical. It is our go-to system and we prefer it always when it is possible. Note that it is important to choose a good quality gas stove, otherwise some of the features mentioned may not be true for you. For example, it won't be as fast and economical in use. We ourselves didn't have the best gas stove for the longest time and so couldn't enjoy all the benefits it can offer. So it is crucial to choose the right gas stove, and you can watch some of our previous video reviews where we show you what gas system we prefer. Now let's talk about the drawbacks of the gas stove. One of the biggest drawbacks of it maybe is that you need to make sure there is little to no wind for it to work properly. Gas system strongly dislikes the wind, unlike the wood stove. And if you have the windy weather, you need to build the artificial blocks to it, like a sleeping mat for example, or cook inside the tent vestibule. If you count only on the gas system, you should roughly calculate how much you need for the number of days or times you cook to make sure you have enough of it. You have to be sure that you can resupply on gas in the stores you are passing by, otherwise you will be left without cooked meals. That is exactly what happened to us during the Camino de Santiago and several other trails. And if you do depend on such food, it can be a pretty big deal for you. So if your hike passes through the villages with some stores at least once in every 5 to 7 days, and you're sure you'll find some gas there, your choice is obvious, and the best system to go for is the gas one. It has the most advantages to it, and there is no better alternative as far as we know. So it is time to switch to the wood stove system and its advantages. Continuing the topic of resupplying the fuel, here you don't have to worry about not finding the resupply in the nearest store. And you won't encounter yourself in a situation when the store is 70 kilometers away and you are already running out of gas. Here your fuel is always under your feet and it is unlimited. You can use all the twigs, moss, branches, dry grass you can find. And you never think about how much gas is remaining in your container. It just provides you the peace of mind and confidence, and you will always have a hot meal and never have to compromise for any fast food nor canned food. Because you have the possibility of unlimited use of a fuel, you don't have to think about how much of it you spend. Thus, you can boil as many liters of water as you need and do it every day if necessary, because you are not wasting any precious fuel. For example, we enjoyed having our wild shower system during our long distance hikes this summer, and it was possible thanks to it. By the way, you can check out our separate video where we show how we take the shower in the woods, if you are interested. We'll leave the link on the screen and down below. With this system, the presence of the wind actually helps the burning and makes it work more efficiently. So unlike the gas stove system, it will burn better in the wind and it doesn't need to be hidden, which is a huge plus for cooking outdoors because, as you may know, there are a few days with no wind. Now getting to the disadvantages of the wood stove system. In comparison to the gas stove, cooking does take longer time. Boiling takes at least twice as long after setting up a fire. But before you have to collect your fuel first, which is normally quite easy if you are in the forest, but still does take some time. Then you have to give all your attention to the process of cooking, partly because it is the fire and you have to control it, and partly because the fire goes out very quickly. You need to constantly toss up the new fresh branches and watch the flame. Before setting up a fire, you need to search for the appropriate place where there won't be any danger of burning the surroundings, preferably on the rocks with no dry grass around. Also, there can be quite a lot of smoke coming from it, so it is better to make sure you set it up on the distance from your tent and all the things at least 5 to 7 meters away. Otherwise, all the things will have the smell of the smoke, and unless you like it, it can be quite annoying. So all of that adds to the time of the cooking itself. If there is a bad weather and it is raining, you don't have the possibility to cook inside your tent vestibule as you do with the gas stove. And finally, because the cooking pot becomes covered with soot, it needs to be stored in a separate bag from the other things so that it doesn't stain your backpack.
So finishing off this video, we want to say that we personally prefer to have all of the benefits of both stoves, and thus we do carry both of them. The gas stove is still remaining our main cooking system, and we have the wood stove as an extra alternative when needed and when we have time to use it. Fortunately, it doesn't add much weight to a pack. We found that combining both of the stoves, we can have the most versatile cooking setup possible.
We hope this video was useful for you and could help to clarify some of your doubts in choosing the best cooking system for you. Let us know in the comments below what is your preferred cooking system and why. It will be very beneficial for us and many other people to know different opinions. We have plenty of other gear reviews on our channel by now, so make sure to check out our dedicated playlist for that. Don't forget to give this video a like if you found it helpful, and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more hiking inspiration, adventures and gear reviews. Click on the notification bell as well to be the first notified when our new video is out.
This is all we wanted to share with you today. Hope you have an amazing day, and we see you all in the next video.
Bye guys!